So everyone take a breath. Take a breath in and out. Technology is great till it's not. So welcome everybody to this morning's Christmas morning service. And I am going to share my screen because I went ahead and got and put the prayers and everything on there. Here we go. Okay, and share sound. If you, I'm good, I just did share sound. So when we do the music, you should hear. If you do not hear something, feel free to write something in chat or go like this, actually go like this so I know. So again, welcome everyone. We are an open and affirming church, and no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. And of course, let's see. There we go. So welcome everyone. Good morning. Merry Christmas to everyone online. Last night was such a wonderful night for me, and I'm so thankful we were able to be together. Priscilla, in preparation for today's service, was kind enough to send some music that that they sang, that y'all sang in previous years, which include Colin and Karen for the prelude and the postlude. And then, if you happen to be at the service that Priscilla recorded, you'll hear your own voice there, the congregation singing. Now, I'm not quite sure how Zoom and us singing along will sound. We can give it a try. And if it doesn't work well, we can just mute ourselves and sing at home while we listen to our voices from the past. And as I mentioned a few moments ago, if you want coffee at any time, just feel, or hot chocolate, feel free to go and grab one as we settle in and listen to Colin on the trumpet as we begin and worship together. Lovely. He did such a great job. He always does. So now please join me, either muted or not, in the land acknowledgement. We are not the first peoples on this land, nor
will we be the last.
Teach us to build good soil and to be good ancestors. So you're welcome to unmute. We're going to try it. It sounds a little breaking up, but we can try the call to worship. It's us together. And the bolded is you all, and I am the unbolded. So let's give this a whirl. We waited.
And imagined.
We imagined power.
One like the world, but stronger and on our side.
We imagined a king on a white horse wielding a sword.
We got a baby born in a stable among the livestock.
We imagine the work done for us through the destruction of our enemies.
We receive a baby who will teach us our calling to seek reconciliation and to love expansively.
Praise be to God for the unexpected babe of Bethlehem.
Praise to the wisdom of love.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So this is Orient Congregation. And again, however you're more comfortable with, just us. If you just want to listen or sing muted, that's fine with me. The words are on the screen. So whatever you feel most centered for yourself this morning, you're welcome to do. So before we start the text this morning, which is from Isaiah, the third Isaiah, whose words are just as alive as the first Isaiah yesterday night we heard, Well, as I was listening to the song and the voices from the past, I was just struck just how beautiful each of our voices, as we add them, are to the services that we do and to the time that we are sent together. So I invite you to settle in and listen to these words from Isaiah 52. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices. Together they sing for joy, for in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. May God bless the hearing and the listening and the acting on this Christmas day and in this year to come for each of us today. Okay, and hopefully I can get this back when we go back, but so I wanted to just share a few words, and starting with, it is funny how sometimes you run across things that you're not quite expecting. So I don't know if anyone else, or I know one year she spoke at the annual meeting, Diana Butler Bass. But this morning, as I checked my own email, I saw this, and I'm just going to read just a few words from it, because it kind of goes with this whole idea of the feet of those who speak the word. On Christmas morning, the lectionary, and we're not doing the lectionary, but it gives two gospel readings. One is from Luke and one is from John. And Luke's birth narrative, which we did hear last night that I was so thankful for from our wonderful children and others in the congregation, is all the different things that we heard were beautifully done. But here, going back to Diana Butler Bass, so that idea of the Christmas story soaring with poetic imagery, and they kind of point to the same spiritual truth. God is with us here in history, on earth, and in our flesh. This isn't a story about heaven. It's a story of the world for humans and all creations. And yes, the stories do portray miracles, wonders, and mysteries, images of angels and the deep reaches of time, but they also talk about things of the world, the tax collectors, uncomfortable travel, no hotel vacancies, sound familiar, and an untimely birth and a hope for certain peace on earth. And through all these terrible things and burdensome things, the very breath of God and the word since before the beginning joins our bodies and shares our lives. As poet Madeline L'Engle puts it, the maker of the stars was born. And how, and I liked it because even though we're not doing those other two texts today, it goes with this Isaiah text. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messengers who announce peace. And I do believe, as part of, you know, Orient Congregational Church, that we do that. We do that, and you know, whether you're always online, Carol that comes and joins us, and other people that are part of the community, like last night from the children's co-op, it works, and people get to hear about God and God's love. You could see the return in Isaiah's words of the Lord to Zion. And for us, we can continue to see God's word for us each day. That we see as God bears his holy or her or they holy arm, we can act and we can be present. And I love this part with, even though I'm not a singer, we all know that, break forth into singing. For me, that idea even of the spoken word, whatever it is, that we can do that. We can be present. We can be those like Isaiah that speak God's word. And we do already. But we can be reminded as we get ready on this wonderful Christmas day to continue to listen and be on those mountains of the world, the feet of the messenger, the ones that are actually doing the work. Because many people, even if God's voice was booming from somewhere, they may not hear it, but they might be more apt to hear your voice, to see your actions. And that the idea that God has and continues and will always comfort his people. And that it is so beautiful. And when you think about it with even the Old Testament in the first century, and even now, those of us who wear sandals or flip-flops in the summer, our feet are not the most beautiful part of us, are they? And yet they get us from one place to another place. They enable us to go and do what is needed. So as we go forth this week, as we prepare for this new year, I am thankful that each of us have that choice and how beautiful each one of our feet is. Amen. So what I was planning, and I, you know, what do they say? The best plan, the less laid plans of men and mice or whatever that is, I forget. But for a sharing together, if there's anything, perhaps it's from last night or today, or maybe it's just something you've been considering, if anyone would like to share at this point with us. And again, remembering that we are recording. So whatever you like to share that you don't mind if other people not on this call will hear. Okay, so that's fine. And other times we can. Oh, we got someone else here. Dan. Let me get him in. Hi, Dan. Welcome.
Hi, Mary. Thank you for doing this today.
You're welcome. We kind of were just getting to the time of prayer. We were just, we're going to do a hymn, so you'll get to hear that also. We were just finishing a time of sharing or sitting in silence together. So what I'm going to do is hit the share button again. And you'll see the words. And for Dan, that hasn't been on it yet. But we made a video of different of this song that Priscilla sent me. And it's What Child Is This? So again, everyone take a time perhaps for prayer and just to listen to these words as they are sung by our own Orient Congregational Church. If I can make this work. There we go.
Thank you.
And as we remember, what child is this who grew up to be our Savior, who touched the world and touched us all the time in so many different ways. We are thankful, God, for how you sent this child to be a part of our world and to bring light out of darkness and to help us as we walk on our paths. If anyone, again, if you feel comfortable sharing online, you're welcome to unmute and share a prayer if you like, and then we'll sit in a little time of silence. So God, as we open our hearts in the quiet, we are thankful for your love. And as we do sit, everyone is invited to remember perhaps one person or a few people that you may not have seen, or perhaps it's just somebody that needs, that God is putting on your heart to pray for as you sit in the silence for just a little while. Let us pray. And out of the quiet of the dawn comes the voices of the world. And as we remember the story of Christmas, the story, God, of your son coming in a world that wasn't ready, and yet the shepherds welcomed him. The angels cried out, and the magi joined them. And we too can bring our voices. And God, we open our hearts to you on this day and all days, and that we know that you love us and watch out for us. We thank you and say a prayer for those who are working today, those in hospital, those EMTs, police, for those who got called into work today that weren't expecting it, and for others are spending time with their families and being present for their children, grandchildren, spouses, and all, that we can remember on this day that sometimes can get a little bit heavy, God, that you are there, and that we can remember that you are always present with us, like that shepherd in Psalm 23. That we shall not want, because you are here with us. You guide us through the pitfalls of life, and you're always present with us, including that time that we can remember that Jesus sent his disciples out several different times. And at one point they asked him, how do we pray? And he taught them what's come to be known as the Lord's Prayer. And I invite everyone to join me in this prayer, which you'll see on your screen right now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. So again, as we leave this place, this safe place, and perhaps today is a day that we may just be staying home, but tomorrow, as we go out in this world, that we know that we are called to speak the word and the words and tell and retell those stories from a long time ago, or even those that we've seen miracles yesterday or today. So I call on each of you to just walk boldly as you are bold people, and know that God will be right there for you. And as we prepare to leave, I'm going to play this song. It's called, I could only find the creche, which I thought was kind of apropos, is Rise Up, Shepherds, and Follow. And Priscilla was so kind to share this. This is actually Karen's voice. And if you want to stay on after the postal for a few minutes and chat, you're more than welcome to do so. We can stop the recording then. And for right now, though, let's listen to this postlude. I am so thankful that all of you joined us. And for those who may listen to this recording later on in the week or in the weeks to come, I'm thankful for you also. So as we prepare to end this time on this Christmas morning, when we all have different things we may do, just to keep in our minds just how much God loves us and how much the story that we've heard last night and we shared even part of it today is so important to our lives and those we meet in the world. Amen.